Since 1970, Adidas has been designing the balls for the FIFA World Cup. Our question? What does mathematics say about these designs? First, we need to understand the five Platonic solids: the tetrahedron, the cube, the octahedron, the dodecahedron, and the icosahedron. Each of these solids has congruent faces. For example, the cube has six square faces, and each corner is met by three edges, while the icosahedron has 20 triangular faces, and each corner connects five edges. The structure of the World Cup balls are each based on one of these Platonic solids. The Telstar, introduced in 1970, is the classical design with its 12 black pentagons and 20 white hexagons. It's not a Platonic solid, but it's one step away. Start with an icosahedron. Pick a corner, divide its connecting edges into thirds, mark a pentagon, then cut off the corner. Doing this to each of the 12 corners creates 12 pentagonal faces. Pumping it up produces the Telstar. Now look at the next 8 World Cups: the Telstar Duralast, the Tango España, the Azteca, the Etrusco Unico, the Questra, the Tricolor, and the Fever Nova. Although they have different printed patterns, the physical panels with 20 hexagons and 12 pentagons is the same as the 1970 Telstar. This all changed with the 2006 Teamgeist in Germany. It has 6 dumbbell-shaped panels and 8 propeller shapes. Unlike the Telstar's panels, which are stitched together, the Teamgeist panels are thermally bonded. This ball received criticism because of its erratic flight. How is the Teamgeist made from a Platonic solid? Start with a cube. Like before, pick a corner, divide the connecting edges into thirds, then slice off the corners. Doing this to each corner produces the truncated cube with 6 octagons and 8 triangles. To get the Teamgeist, identify each octagon with a dumbbell-shaped panel and each triangle with a propeller shape. Reshaping the panels and inflating it produces the Teamgeist. And don't be fooled by a fake Teamgeist, which prints the Teamgeist pattern onto a Telstar design. In 2010, the South African World Cup introduced the Jabulani. While a casual look suggests that there are many panels, there are really only 8. 4 round panels and 4 propellers. This ball was also criticized for beach ball-like flight, possibly due to its shallow seams. For its design, start with the tetrahedron and truncate the 4 corners to produce 4 triangular faces and 4 hexagonal faces. Identifying the triangles with the ovals and the hexagons with the propellers, then reshaping, produces the Jabulani. This brings us to the 2014 Brazuca, debuted in Brazil. Named by the fans, this ball has only 6 panels, the fewest yet. These 6 propellers correspond to the faces of a cube. The propellers don't overlap, just like the faces of the cube don't overlap. You can also see this connection from the seams. 3 seams meet at a corner, just like 3 edges meet at a corner of a cube. Reshaping the squares into the propellers produces the Brazuca. So with all of these different balls, which one is your favorite?